Hey, happy Victoria Day. Today, we're going to be playing Disney Golf. I figured Canada and Scotland are the only two countries that celebrate Victoria Day, and the Scottish invented golf, so I figured why not. Hopefully this will work. I haven't played this game in quite a while. And it does, it's a bit glitchy, but hopefully it'll be alright. I do have also golf for the Game Boy, which my Uncle Brian used to play all the time when he babysat me. But I have more fond memories of this one. If you hear a noise in the background, that's the humming of the PlayStation. It's noisy because of the disc. I did clean it, but it's one of those blue discs, so they're a lot noisier than regular games. I love Goofy, but I'm probably going to play as Donald. Because when you're playing golf, you might as well have your Happy Gilmore character, someone who's going to be fun to watch while he gets ticked off. If I had a choice, I would probably play as Pete. Because he's funnier than Donald in this circumstance, but who knows, maybe they'll play together. Start a game. 18 holes. One player. Oh, I do get to play as Pete.
Well,
yeah, I'm gonna play as him. Sorry. I know I said Donald, but, yeah, I'm gonna play as Pete. Just trying to pick the nice place for it. Since Victoria's day is all about getting ready for the summer, I think I'm gonna go with the tropical cruise. Tropical course. Select an item. Some protein. Technique, power up, one of those, and we're good. I don't even know if I'm going to use any of that stuff. I don't remember how to use it, but it's there if I need it. The wind is going a little that way. Ball's over there. It's only 6 miles per hour. Okay. Let's just give her. Oh. Not my best shot.
Second stroke.
Yeah, that's better. I don't know who I'm playing against. I guess I'm not playing against anybody. I thought I would be. So.
Oh.
so it's a little curved. Oh, that bogey. Plus one. Of course, the object of the game is, as you probably already know, is to get the lowest score, not highest score. And it's, it's kind of weird playing it by myself. I kind of wish I had an opponent. But that's alright. It's still fun. And I'm getting practice that I much needed. I was still used to play the Grand Theft Auto golf. That's fun. That's from GTA 5 with the Grand Theft Auto golf. Oh, it looks like the wind is shining.
Second stroke. Now remember how the rough is going to affect the shot.
Par 5, so I made par. That means I broke even. Looks like it's a short one. And it's gonna push back. So a little. Hopefully I don't overshoot it. Oh. I had a feeling I should have undershot that. Par 3. Broke even again, so I'm still plus one. I want to get at least down to zero. Now I'm just rushing, of course. I don't even see where the hole is. Almost 450 yards away, I'll see it soon. Still on the green.
You want to put this one near the pin.
There it is. And it looks like the wind is blowing straight forward. So I'm going to duck it a little bit, not hit it really hard. I hope that was a screwball. Okay.
remember how the...
I'm gonna underplay it. I probably shouldn't have underplayed it. Yeah, I was right. Sometimes you have to listen to the guides, sometimes you don't. And I bogeyed it. Thank you. Whoa. Yards away. I think I'm on the green.
Second stroke.
Yeah, the wind is pushing a little backwards. So just give her. Maybe not just give her. Anyway, I can... There we go. I'll just go over the rock. Oh yeah, I'm doing terrible.
Don't try to snatch the ball.
Maybe there's no way to make it over.
Be careful of that wind.
How high can I go? That's as high as I can go. I know it's crazy, but I'm just stubborn enough to try and figure out if I can go over the wall. Nice!
Now remember how the rough is going to affect the shot.
Damn, learn it already. Even if I am doing terrible at this point. Oh! 1 yard away. I have to admit, losing is funnier than winning.
This hole bends.
Little thunderstorms. And I have no idea where it's supposed to be. There it is.
Don't try to snatch the ball.
So let's go over the shot again. Let's go as high as I can go. I know I'll probably regret it, but... Okay. It was a bad move. I should have went around. Alright, time to play it smart, I guess. I always miss by just a fraction. Double bogey. Double bogey always makes me think of Suicide Squads with, there's a lot of actors in it, but most importantly, Leonard from Big Bang Theory, when he was trying to remember his parents' security password, and then he's just like, double the thing with the putter, double bogey, double fucking bogey. There's no need for profanities here. There we go. Let's play it smart. Oh, that wasn't because I was overthinking. As soon as I made that shot, I was looking at the arrow and I was like, maybe I should have played it a little this way. I wasn't paying attention to the wind. Okay, so let's push it a little louder. Play it smart, Jason. Play it smart. The ground's wet, though. This is still not my worst game of golf. The worst game of golf was the very first time I ever tried it in real life. I think my score was probably plus 143 or something like that. I would knock it about 2 feet, 3 feet, 5 feet, and then just keep walking. I've gotten better at practicing at the driving range nowadays. Oh, there, the weather picked up. But yeah, the first time was, I was terrible. Oh, just wanted to land on the green. I probably could play this better if I knew the course. But it's been a long time since I've played this.
You're on the green. Think this.
There we go. There he is. You broke even, Pete.
Plus eight. At least it's not worse than that.
Okay. I have a feeling about this one. Probably gonna knock it out of bounds. Hey, it's a perfect shot though.
Nice shot.
Nice, 311 yards. I'm gonna decide to underplay it just a little bit so that it doesn't overshoot it. There, now that was a smart move. I had a feeling it would just, you know, bounce right on the hole and then knock it right out like it did the earlier. Oh, that's the J factor right there.
That's far.
made par, but you could have done better than that, Pete. You could have been a +7 instead of a +8. Halftime energy recovery. I didn't even know I was low on energy. 500 yards.
Be careful of that pin.
Let's nail it as far as possible. Okay, it wasn't a perfect shot. That would have nailed it. That's alright. I'm on the green. 305 yards. That's still pretty good. Oh. Don't sand trap it. And I overshot it. Of course. Just gotta know when to underplay it. Just once, can you just hit the beam and go right in? Oh, birdie, nice.
Nice birdie!
Yeah! Nice job, Pete. There you go, you're +7.
Not bad! Not bad.
Alright, Pete, let's see you do another birdie. A par 4. 370 yards. You can do a good 300 yard shot. So let's see it. Kind of underplayed it. I didn't plan on underplaying it. In the dirt. Time to make up for it. Oh, nice.
You're cutting, Bob.
Another birdie shot, but I'm still pretty far away from it, and it's, if I know the J factor, I'm going to miss this. Oh! Finally some luck.
I mean, finally some luck.
There we go, +6. Let's keep going towards zero. So that we can come out even. Oh, there's 18 holes. I don't think I can do it. Par 4. Wind is really pushing this way, so.
Don't try to catch the ball.
Hopefully I won't regret this. Oh, that was a risk.
Now remember how the rock is going to affect the shot.
Another birdie shot. Play it smart, Pete.
Too bad.
Oh.
Too bad. That's
hard. He tried. That's the J factor. But still, that wasn't bad. You had a lot of luck there. Had a hitting it over a friggin' lake and a small pond. Or stream or whatever. So. This is 150 yards. I'm gonna have to underplay this. Because otherwise it's gonna bounce on the hole and knock it right out. Let's go for somewhere in between. That's not bad. I was afraid of that. Still broke even. I'm not good at the long shot of putting, obviously.
Thank you.
reach the ball. It's uphill to the cup. Nice putt!
Leave it.